fragrance you're wearing.
Statement without saying a word.
I tell my patients that it's important that they not only get a diaper that protects against leaks, but it's important that a diaper keep a baby's skin dry. Dryness helps to promote healthy skin. These issues are more important to me because I'm Ashley's father.
Introducing a diaper with the air dry system. Different because now the top sheet has air pockets right underneath, so it can absorb irritating wetness almost instantly. Wetness goes down into a lockaway core. Air goes up, leaving the top sheet so dry, you can prove it with powder.
Ashley liked the diaper very well. If a parent were to ask me, I would recommend this diaper.
What a great improvement. Today's Ultra Pampers Plus with the air dry system. Because healthy skin begins with dry skin.
When you go shopping, you have to find the right fit, style, color.
When you do, you feel great.
But when you also find the Made in the USA label, you feel even better.
It's a great feeling.
Made in the USA.
Mom, Dad, what are we doing in here? We're all cooped up. The light's bad, the air's stale. It just isn't us.
We're born to be wild.
Ross, I know you have your learner's permit and we know how badly you want to drive, but we don't need anything just now. Maybe later?
Fine. Later. Later is good. Ready?
Don't worry, Granddad will be here soon. Maybe he'll need something somewhere.
You can help me clean up if you want.
I'm a driver. I think cleaners is a different union.
I can't wait till Dad gets here. He's never even seen the preschool.
It has been quite a while.
Hey, you remember the last time he was here? He packed the weekend with athletic events. It was like the Olympics, only with fewer interruptions.
Hi-ho, everyone.
Dad! Hey!
Come on up. Hey, Emily, how are you? Hey, Ross. How you doing?
Hey.
Well,
it's great to see you, dear.
It's good to be here. You know who I was thinking about the other day? Ed Sullivan.
Every Sunday night, just you, me, and Ed.
Friend of the family?
No, it's a TV show, Ross. The guy who starred in it never moved his neck. Anyway, they had these Romanian acrobats on there. We used to do that trick. Come on, Brian, we'll show them.
Come on, Dad's been a long, long time.
Well, I understand if you're not up to it, then we don't have to go ahead and do
it. I'm up to it.
Oh, all right.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Hey, 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 hey! You look great, Brian.
Oh, thanks. So do you. How's Mom?
Miserable. She couldn't come. Couldn't get away from work. Hey, Kate, you look fat. Fantastic. You look 20 years old.
Oh, I don't look that young.
You sure do. In fact, you look 19.
Oh, okay.
And Emily, why, she's practically a full-grown woman.
Granddad's sense of age is really out of kilter.
No, it isn't.
Look what Granddad has for you, Emily.
Don't you think she's a little young for football, Granddad? I mean, she can't even throw applesauce yet.
Yes, she can.
What are you talking about? All it is the pillow. Whoops. Caught you sleeping. Put her there. Come on. Granddad, hey, how are you?
Good morning, beautiful. And may I say that your radiance outshines even the sun today.
All right, I'll take out the trash.
Already did. You know, I was thinking when I was a little boy, I used to come downstairs in the morning. My dad would always be the first one up and be having his coffee. But now I'm the man of the house. And now my dad is going to come down my stairs and see me having my coffee.
Ha! You're up finally.
Why, I don't know. I never saw such a bunch of snoozers. You're going to wake up one morning and find out that you're as old as I am and you won't know how it happened.
With that coffee?
Yeah.
That'll kill you.
Jack, I can hardly keep up with you. How do you stay in such great shape?
No secret, really. I eat whatever I want.
Jack, if I didn't know better, I'd swear you were a descendant of the Wongo tribe of Micronesia. Oh, he gets that all the time. No, really. I did a paper on the Wongos. All of their athletic champions are over the age of 60.
What do their cheerleaders look like?
I better get to work, Jack. Okay, kids, morning yoga.
A lovely girl. Ran 4 miles with her this morning. She talked all the way. Lovely. Incoherent, but lovely.
So what do you think of the preschool, Dad?
Well, they look like some strapping young fellas. You teach sports here, football, baseball?
Well, we've really been concentrating on weightlifting.
Well, that's a serious business, Kate. You can't start too early turning these boys into men.
Brian, when are we baking muffins?
Right after nap time, Justin.
Can I wear the apron?
Sure you can.
Oh, boy.
Hi, Granddad.
Hi, Ross. Hey, what are you doing this afternoon? I thought we might go driving.
Be still my heart. Did you say driving?
Well, your father tells me you're a hell of a driver.
I think I said he's hell on wheels.
Oh, sure, like no one else has ever hit a coffee shop.
That Emily has quite an arm, doesn't she?
You wouldn't think that applesauce would be so aerodynamic.
I still don't know how she got the tapioca up on the chandelier.
Oh, Mom, that was me. So what'd you guys do today? Well, Granddad was on a mission. First, we went to the sporting goods store.
Brian, he doesn't have a baseball glove.
Well, there's a reason for that.
Yeah. We went to the park after to do a little basketball. He had no idea what a slam dunk meant.
I always assumed it involved donuts.
Granddad! Oh.
Hey! What a grip! What a woman! Hey, how about having dinner with us tomorrow?
Oh, I can't. I'm booked. I've got a corporate Raiders dinner dance.
Involved in some takeovers recently?
Oh, yeah. You know that cute little old lady with the little kitty cat on the TV commercials? Granny Wilson's Quilts and Comforters?
Yeah.
We pulled the rug out from under her. She was taken over by a conglomerate, International Pesticides and Explosives.
Always nice to see the good guys win.
Oh, let's not cry bitter tears for Granny Wilson, Brian. I sat across the bargaining table from that blue-haired shark. She kept staring at me with those beady little eyes behind her bifocals.
I hope you kick some butt.
I kicked it from Maine to Spain. You know, those Raiders can have their dinner dance without me. I'll see you tomorrow night.
Well, how was Thanksgiving at Aunt Betty's this year?
Oh, it was quite a spread. Potatoes, yams, rice, stuffing.
Kind of a festival of starches.
And you played the traditional before Thanksgiving football game.
Never heard of it.
Brian, that's a Harper tradition. You always loved it.
Well, Ross isn't really that into football.
Oh, of course not. You don't play football with him. Someone throws a football at your head, you get into football pretty quick.
I remember. You broke my nose.
I thought you were lucky.
Ross, why don't you come help me with the dishes?
Oh, sure. How about some traditional Harper and Son brandy?
Ross is not into football. Gee. As a boy, football was such a big part of my life. It's a shame that Ross is going to miss out on all of that and all the other things. Sure.
What do you mean?
Well, Brian, I was with the boy all afternoon. It was really an eye-opener.
Well, personally, when Ross is driving, I like to keep my eyes closed.
So is he. But that's not what worried me.
Worried?
Now, look, I don't like to criticize, but... Well, he doesn't throw too well, and he definitely does not catch well. He's more like a target. Now, Dad, I know it's just a matter of practice, but he's not into any sports at all.
Well, Dad, just because you and I like sports doesn't mean that Ross has to. He's into other things.
Like what?
Listening to music, resting. Resting.
Brian, I'm worried about him.
Oh, come on, Dad. Now, what are you saying?
You gotta watch him. It's like the shoemaker's kid going barefoot. You're watching the four-year-olds all the time. You gotta take a look at your own son, too.
Dad, are you saying you don't think Kate and I are doing a good job?
No. Well, I think Kate's doing a good job. But you're dropping the ball. I mean, Ross needs a man's influence to grow up right.
Dad, there isn't just one way to grow up right. I mean, one of the things we've learned from the preschool is that you have to let children develop in their own way.
Let them develop in their own way. Well, at the rate that he's going, the kid's going to develop into a potato. Okay. Made my point. How about, as long as I'm here, I'll make it a point to try to be with Ross as much as I can. Let's us just say that he'll get the best of both of us.
Well, sure.
I'm glad to be here, Brian. Yeah, that's what grandfathers are for, to fill in the gaps. And there are plenty of gaps.
Guess what? There's no bathroom on the bus.
Relax.
But diarrhea usually comes back.
Took the Imodium AD, didn't you?
Yeah, but just a little cough.
Perfect.
New Imodium AD often stops diarrhea with one dose instead of all those spoonfuls you may need of the leading remedy.
I'm in a rest stop.
You coming?
Nope, I'm fine.
New Imodium AD. It can make your first attack of diarrhea your last.
Another amazing technological breakthrough from Underalls, French-cut Underalls silks.
And no panty lines.
Isn't science gorgeous?
Corning See-Through Vision Saucepan withstands heat that turns ordinary saucepans into sauce. Best of all, it lets you see your meal before it's all over. Visions by Corning. It's a visibly superior gift.
Next, Secret Agents Chevy Chase and Dan Aykroyd are handed a deadly mission.
Oh, with a hot cup of coffee and a handshake.
They'll journey to an exotic foreign land.
Pakistan.
They'll practice diplomacy.
We're Americans!
And they'll ride a camel.
I guess we walk.
It's a network premiere.
There's an airport near here.
Spies Like Us, next. It was a million-dollar heist, and you may hold a clue to catch the thief.
The monies are untraceable.
A bizarre highway attack leaves a town torn apart. And you could have the answer.
That's all we're missing. One small link. Someone out there has it.
Don't let them get away with it. Catch a criminal on Unsolved Mysteries Wednesday.
Is he here?
Is who here?
Don't toy with me, Mom. Granddad has been running me ragged. I'm a mess. I'm a mere shell of the man I was. And the man I was a shell. I'm just not cut out for all this exercise. I'm using muscles I never knew I had. Like my arms.
Does that mean you don't want to go skeet shooting?
Skeet shooting? What did those skeets ever do to us?
Ross, I agree. Granddad's gone a little too far. But his heart's in the right place.
Oh, then what's gotten into him? I mean, in the old days when he visited, he'd just pull a silver dollar out of my ear. He'd give me piggyback rides and duke it out with Eileen. Now he's just throwing things at me. Am I supposed to catch them, kick them, or throw them back? I don't know. The rules keep changing randomly.
Well, Ross, have you tried talking to him?
We haven't had any time to talk. Oh, no, I take that back. We had one conversation today about
pectorals.
Pectorals?
Well, they're muscles somewhere in the chesto region. Apparently I have them and I've done nothing with them. Great, now I have to walk around all day with a guilty chest.
Hey, Ross, how you doing? What's with him?
Well, I think all the sudden physical activity has been a shock to his system. I mean, we are talking about a boy who has trouble bench pressing a fork.
You know, I think my dad has a point. We have been dropping the ball with Ross. He's got to toughen up and learn to be a man.
Are you listening to yourself? Dropping the ball, toughen up, be a man.
My dad knows what he's talking about. This is his area, and I want to be the best father I can be.
Brian, you changed your whole life so that you could spend more time with your children. In all fairness, would your father have done that?
Probably not, but he would have loved it. When I was growing up, I didn't get to see my dad much during the week. I'd spend all weekend with him, you know, fishing, hiking, playing ball. Then on Sunday nights, we'd watch Ed Sullivan and Topo Gigio, the Italian mouse.
You loved that mouse, didn't you?
I hated him. And Topo Gigio always came out in the last 10 minutes of the show. That meant the end of the show. The end of the weekend with my dad, the end of time with him. You know, Harper and Son. On Monday morning, I'd get up extra early so I could have breakfast with him. But he'd put on his hat and coat and shake my little hand goodbye and go out the back door. I'd watch him through the window as he got in the car and drove away. I knew I wouldn't see him much again until the next weekend.
Must have been a great father.
He still is. And if he thinks I'm doing something wrong with Ross, then I think I better think about it.
I don't think you're doing anything wrong.
Oh, thanks, Kate, but you're not a Harper man.
Which I presume is one of the reasons you married me.
Hello, Ellen.
Hey, Dad, where you been?
A little stroll. Just short of 9 miles. I'm having the time of my life. And you want to know something? So is Ross.
Yeah, when Ross came home, it was all he could talk about.
Ross is home, great. I'll get the guns.
So anyway, I said to Granny Wilson, what are you looking at? And the old biddy spit at me. So I climbed across the table and I got her in a half Nelson.
Isn't she great? That's what I miss about business, the hand-to-hand combat. Don't you miss that, Brian?
No, I really don't.
Brian, in your heyday, you would have thrown Granny Wilson and her little kitty cat out the window. So, how was skeet shooting?
Ah, well, Ross didn't do too well, I'm afraid.
Well, you've never done it before. Does your shoulder still hurt from the kick?
No, but the back of my head does.
Well, he hit the ground so fast. Brian, how is it you never took Ross shooting? You used to love it.
Well, he's never had an interest in it before, you know. As a matter of fact, Ross's interest in a lot of things has picked up since he's been able to drive us to them.
He's obviously still not interested in haircuts.
Hey, I wore my hair long in my day.
Not in my house. Now, how's he going to play baseball with the hair hanging down over his eyes like that?
Well, he could always put it up in a ponytail.
And then he could come back and bake some muffins, too.
Oh, I love baseball. There is something so attractive about a man in uniform holding a club.
Isn't she great? Well, how about it, Ross? We'll go down to the barber shop tomorrow and we'll get you a major league crew cut. Huh?
Let alone, Dad.
You can't play baseball with a mop like that.
It's Ross's hair, Dad.
Well, what about football season? You can't get all that hair in your helmet.
He doesn't play football.
How about dancing? Girls are not going to want to dance with you. Your hair's going to be longer than theirs.
Come on, Dad, let it go. I mean it.
What'd you say?
Ross is happy with his hair the way it is.
I wouldn't let a young man wearing his hair like that in my house.
Well, Dad, that's just it. This is not your house. This is my house. And I'm afraid we're going to have to leave it at that.
Thanks, Dad.
I see. Well, Kate, thank you for those wonderful meals. Eileen, just terrific seeing you again. Kristen, been great running with you. I have a feeling that I have been here for too long.
That's not true, Dad. Please.
It is true.
Come on, Dad. You're blowing this all out of proportion.
I don't think so. Excuse me.
Well, thanks for the grub. I'm out of here. This is why I don't have a family.
Never thought this would happen. My dad and I get along so well together.
Oh, don't let this bother you.
You know what really bothers me? If I had to do it again, I would. Oh, great. He's called a taxi.
I'll get him.
Has Granddad left yet?
His cab is out front.
Dad, do you mind if I ask you a question?
Go ahead.
Well, when you said that you had long hair, how long?
Well, it wasn't quite as long as yours, but I had sideburns down to here.
What are sideburns?
Forget I mentioned it.
You know, when you were arguing with Granddad, I saw a side to you that I've never seen before.
What's that?
You're a son.
What?
Well, whenever you and I fight, you know, I always see you as the dad. But when I saw you two fighting, I realized, hey, Dad's a son. It really blew my mind. And you know what else? As in every other argument of this kind, the son is always right.
Go to your room.
I tell the cab to wait.
Dad.
All packed.
I don't want you to go.
Have to. Your mother can't be trusted alone. She's probably already changed the kitchen tiles.
Well, she's been threatening to do that for years.
Well, I'll be sure to tell everyone as well, and, thank you, Brian. I've had a wonderful time.
Dad, wait. I want you to know I'm sorry.
Not for what you said.
I'm sorry your feelings were hurt. I just thought you were being a little hard on my son.
Well, I think you're being too easy on him.
Yeah, well, I think that's my call. It's not that I don't want your opinion.
Oh, Brian, now, face it. You don't want my opinion at all. I should have figured that out. I was acting like Ross's father, not his grandfather. I guess I got so used to the idea of Harper and Son, I forgot that there's a new Harper and Son. Now, it's just that the new Harper doesn't seem to care whether his son gets into sports or not.
Does it really bother you that much?
It bothers the hell out of me. If he was my son, I'd be pushing him all the time into football and hockey and soccer and baseball and track and kickboxing. But that's me. That's not you.
Can you live with it?
I don't think it makes any difference, does it?
It doesn't?
You remember the time at that county fair when the boys were picking on you, you couldn't even pick up that sledgehammer to ring the bell?
They couldn't either.
That's right. That's why I made them come up and try. You remember the laugh we had at that? Come on, sit down here.
How can I forget?
If we watch those boys struggling with that sledgehammer, and we're just sitting there just laughing. Then you looked over at me. Had a very special look in your eye. It made me feel like a hero.
You were.
I'll never forget that look. I saw it again tonight, only this time it wasn't in your eyes, it was in Ross's. Just after you shut me down. He looked over you and he said, thanks, Dad. You're his hero, Brian.
I'm not his hero. Barney Rubble's his hero.
Well, I tell you, if Ross makes you feel half as loved as you've always made me feel, then you do all right.
Will you stay?
No. Time to go anyway. Time to leave you alone with your son. And besides, I'm bushed. It just dawned on me recently how exhausting it is being me.
I stalled the cab driver as long as I could, but he said he didn't come to this country to wait around for you.
Okay, I'm going.
You know, Dad, I could have driven you.
Dad.
Or Ross.
No. No, that's not necessary. Well, so long, Ross.
Bye, Granddad. Come back soon.
A lot of kids wear their hair like that, don't they?
A lot of them.
I still can't stand it.
Well, why do you think we're doing it?
Bye, Dad.
Kate. Oh, thank you for everything. You give Emily a kiss for me, will you?
In a minute.
Discover the fragrance of America. Lady Stetson. You're free. Playing in the big leagues. Country proud. With a fragrance all your own. Lady Stetson. Capturing the essence and spirit of the American woman. An exciting blend of contrasts, like America itself. Lady Stetson.
She's got a leg. Sheer elegance legs.
Some women live in sheer elegance. The pantyhose that looks and feels like real silk from the Orient.
She's got a leg.
It's inevitable.
Put a new shirt on your child.
And it comes back looking like he went to war instead of the first grade.
But rejoice.
There's New Bounce with Stain Guard.
It can make some clothes so stain resistant.
Even grass stains wash out like this.
New Bounce with Stain Guard. Stains get on, but they don't stay in.
Next, Spies Like Us. Chevy Chase and Dan Aykroyd are coming your way in a zany adventure of international espionage. And Monday night on NBC, a heartwarming holiday drama. I'll Be Home for Christmas, starring Hal Holbrook, Eva Marie Saint, and Family Ties Courtney Cox, Monday.
Sit, Ubu, sit. Good dog.
He wants to name the baby Christina or Christopher.
She prefers Adriana or Adam.
Help us name our baby.
And settle this argument.
Now, this isn't an argument. To vote for Adriana or Adam, call 1-900-220-2300.
To vote for Christina or Christopher, call 1-900-220-2311. Each call costs 50 cents.
You decide for all of us in San Juan.
NBC News at this hour. I'm Connie Chung. In Armenia, 200 factory workers were rescued virtually unharmed from the basement of their plant. They were trapped by debris after an earthquake that killed an estimated 45,000 people. 78 Soviet soldiers and crew members were killed when a plane carrying them on a rescue operation crashed. In eastern Afghanistan, a Pakistani Air Force jet shot down an Afghan passenger plane, killing 25 people. 40 people are believed to have died when a fireworks store blew up in Mexico City. Palestinians called a general strike in the Gaza Strip today. 3 Israeli soldiers and 7 Palestinians were hurt in disturbances in the occupied territories. More news later on this NBC station.